30 years from now, you're hired to write for Stranger Things. That's set in the late 2010s, what nostalgic things or situations do you put on the show? Smartphones. Everyone has one, but things are going to be different in 30 years. I don't know how, but it will. I'd make fidget spinners scary. Will ends up getting captured into the Upside Down after he went wandering around at night playing Pokemon Go. Billy rolls up in a decked-out Shelby GT500 blaring five-finger death punch. He trains in MMA. Instead of long hair, he has a lame butt man bun. Steve drives an M3 and has his own YouTube channel on Style for Guys. All the boys being nerds play World of Warcraft. Joyce works at Walgreens yet passes another one on her way home from work. Marvel movies. 80s nostalgia. A load of memes that absolutely no one will remember. Spending loads of time messing around on Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat. The send nudes memes. I would use the melody of Despacito as a recurring theme throughout the episodes, first as an upbeat lively tune, and then slowly begin using it for the darker parts of the episodes. Clown sightings of 2016. Will gets therapy for his PTSD, but it's actually helpful because we know more about PTSD 30 years later. Also, WikiHow articles on how to eat a Demogorgon. The show culminates in breaking 11 out of Area 51 on September 20, 2019. Game of Thrones would be popular along with Breaking Bad. The Avengers. From a more nerdy pov, I'd say that most nerd things are accepted now, and so we'd have to make really niche interests for them to be bullied for enjoying. Netflix branding would be huge. Donald Trump drama would be playing in the background on the news a lot. Along with ignored segments about global warming. Dustin has an outlandish tech YouTube channel with a huge following. Nancy toys with being an Instagram influencer just to save up money for her dreams, but she hates herself for it and eventually stops. Will starts vaping and the gang finally gets concerned for him, saying, "People say that's actually pretty bad for you." Mike's mom gets addicted to Netflix binging and starts to let herself go and become unaware of her surroundings. Playing my new VR headset while charging my Tesla at the charging station. Also, we don't have to wear respirators outside. Cars that we have to drive. Oddly enough, D&D would still work. The kids are really into heavily modding Skyrim, which is seen as uncool at their school. All the older women at the poolside have heavily contoured faces and large fake butts. Max listens to Billie Eilish, Jonathan Byers listens to Joji, Dustin is trying to get Steve into XXXTentacion. I guess Old Town Road at this point. Soulja Boy. Every generation needs to know true suffering at least once in their lives. Billy wears a MAGA hat and is really into QAnon YouTube videos. Will's dad is an opioid addict. All the kids are super into Fortnite and talk on Discord instead of hanging out IRL. Losing the TV remote and then remembering that you have an app that can be used as a TV remote. And #X200B, and #X200B, edit, holy s, it. I never thought my top post, comment would be about those TV remote apps. Thank you, and #X200B, edit 2, thanks for the silver, kind stranger, it's my first one. CrossFit. Keto. Wireless earbuds. Exploring Polly. Candy Crush, stupid but fits. Old people yearning for anti-intellectualism. Tesla's breakout. The weird red embrace. Self-checkouts. Plastic fear. Weed breakout. Bitcoin. YouTube influencers. A Lady Ghostbusters reference, because it also pays homage to the original Stranger Things. People outdoors during summer months. Everyone in the show talks about 90s nostalgia all the time. Minecraft, just Minecraft. We have Herobrine as the bad guy and Notch as Hopper. The monsters are the modded creepers that have four long legs. Phineas and Ferb, Planet 51, Minecraft, Beyblade, silly bands. Reading so much of the replies, and you can already tell the replies aren't from youth who grew up in the 2010s. Dustin sings that Meet Me in the Middle song to his idiot girlfriend, and the other guys in the gang beat him to death with lead pipes. They will probably use Discord. Definitely gamers, but I don't think they'd play major games like Fortnite. They also use phones instead of their walkie-talkie. Instead of LOTR, I think they'd do Harry Potter or Game of Thrones. And #X200B, they'd also probably talk about Nintendo, and I bet you they like memes. DND is probably replaced by video games in general, like maybe they are video game classes instead. The Avenue Club would be replaced by the Computing Club probably. Imagine 30 years from now we have beat ALS. Some nanotech, stem cell, whatever stops this awful thing in its tracks, and no one has gotten it in like 2 decades. So for the reboot you have the kids doing the ice bucket challenge, and whichever one of them has been taken over by the mind flayer seems to want to do it way too often. Marvel and the Nintendo Switch. Mining cryptocurrency. Opening scene of season 1 will be a bunch of middle schoolers in the basement ripping fat hits off their jewels. I would set it in Arizona and have a weather report with the reporter saying, it's going to be a hot one tomorrow, highs of 99 degrees, and people would be all like, ha, remember Arizona? The kids end every sentence with yeet. The group faces a great divide caused by PewDiePie versus T-Series. Someone buys a single-use bottle of water then chucks the empty bottle in a bin. Someone gets a coffee in a cup, then chucks it as someone says, hey, you know you can't recycle those, right? There are loads of references to Harry Potter and Game of Thrones throughout. A group of friends go out to a restaurant and eat masses of steak, ribs and other meat-based food. A parent says to their kid, and what animal goes bees? Q audience, WTF, a bee. Whenever there is a conversation about anything, someone says, hang on, I've got the Wikipedia page up. Someone is an online influencer who has millions of viewers. They use this fame to talk about environmental responsibility and global warming, in between their hundred of new haul videos where they order huge numbers of brand new junk clothes from Amazon. Politicians deny climate change is a thing in the background on television. You know that new animated The Lion King that's coming out in 2049? It's a remake of the live-action one that came out in 2019, so I'll have a poster of that original live-action version in the background somewhere. D&D would still be a big part of it, but it's considered cool instead of just dorky. Original Stranger Things playing in the background. Taylor Swift songs, smartphones, memes, yoga pants. TikTok. Dustin is a total garbage poster and will struggles to come out to his friends as a weeb. Fedoras and vests are popular by Jason Mraz before Nice Guys ruined the fashion. Lost is the number one show, people are in love with Britney Spears, T-Pain and Flo Rida is featured in every song, David Guetta is at its peak. Bell-bottom jeans were sexy, so was the whale tail. The first smartphone came out without the selfie cam, so mirror selfies were huge. Also, DDD was a term to call someone stupid. Edit, I thought the post was referencing before 2010. Tons of quotes from The Office. Death by planking. Being able to get water out of taps. Being able to get clean water. The days before real-world pop-up ads targeted via facial recognition software. Being able to go outside between the hours of 11 a.m. and 4 p.m., during the time before daily heat advisories. Most people not wearing dust masks in public. The city of Los Angeles. Human employees in counter service jobs. Truck drivers. Eleven freaks out and blows up a phone with her powers after seeing herself in a Snapchat filter for the first time. Op is trying to imply that fluffing Fortnite dances are on the same level as a national treasure like Weird Al. Downvoted, reported, called the cops. Those hilarious old external phones. They look like bricks. You have to type with your finger. I honestly just want some form of media where kids actually say bruh. That one summer of Pokemon Go. I'm already nostalgic for it, TBH. Russian cyber attacks. Tide pods in every candy dish. Virtual reality Dungeons and Dragons. The 2 weeks of Pokemon Go madness. Epic Minecraft song parodies. What you're asking is which cultural touchstones people in the 2040s will associate with the people of today. So I guarantee you would see teenage girl culture, One Direction, Twilight, the Kardashians, lying on Instagram, etc. You would see a lot of teenage boy culture, Minecraft, Skyrim, being angry on the internet. And you'll see superheroes and Harry Potter showing up. Music-wise, you'll see a lot of Taylor Swift and Ed Sheeran. A lot of hipster aesthetic too, undercut hairstyles, messy bobs, beards, tartan shirts, etc. Helicopter parenting and online propaganda would show up, considering the show is about kids. If the show was in the US, you would see stuff about school shootings and fentanyl. I imagine, seeing what's on TV, itself would be shown as something of a relic. It will be a big character trait for someone to be disdainful of the environment, or overly environmentally conscious. A lot of the threats will be based on modern conspiracies like Flat Earth and chemtrails, which are seen as stupid now but will be seen as rose-tinted glasses in the future, where they are no longer taken seriously. Bold to think civilization will still be intact in 30 years.